incomplete to open things up.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
First carry for the 5-time Pro Bowler, LaDainian Tomlinson. Takes it to the 26, just a 1-yard gain.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Third down, a shot here for Dalton. Man open, Rice. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. Dalton, first and 10. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off by George Iloka. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. A first carry now for Doug Martin. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action and hit them over the top.
On second down, here's Wentz. They set up the screen to Martin. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down. So nothing there on the screen that time.
That means all that great acting they tried on offense went for naught, didn't it? Because you have to try and influence them. Make them think that you're doing something else. Make them think that they can get to the passer by letting them by and then setting up the screen and get...
Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
And he slings one that's incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
From midfield here, Dalton. They set up the screen to LT. Look at the dance and the juke. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. Dalton here from the gun. And Tammy with it over the middle. The dump off good for 8 there on first down.
That throw has to be a quarterback's dream, doesn't it? Big tight end curling in the middle of the field, so it's great sight lines for him. And when they show their numbers back to the quarterback, when they sit down right there, that should be pitch and catch.
On second down, it's Tomlinson. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. Here with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It's Orlando in possession of the football here to begin quarter number 2. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. Throwing, Dalton. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. LaDainian Tomlinson, an 18-yard touchdown grab. And his guys are able to strike for six. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So they got him coming up from his linebacker spot.
And sometimes the position designation really doesn't matter. If you creep up to the line of scrimmage, you just have to look for the football. Make sure it moves before you do.
It's up and good, and it'll give his guys a 7-0 lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken short. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. And the Colts getting ready to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Wentz to throw on second down. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. And this is going to be incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
This is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. They go play action here on first down. He's able to hit Joshua Bellamy. And he's taken down deep in their territory. That goes for a gain of 31.
A lot of receivers see the drag route as a risk-reward type of a play. The risk, going into the middle of the field where there's some big people who want to hit you. But the reward is oftentimes you get lost in coverage, running a little bit underneath. And when you catch it just right, as we just saw there, the end result can be a big, big play.
They'll run Martin. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Throwing now is Wentz. Dancing. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Cliff Averill in there to get him for a loss of 5.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. Had to eat it and ended up on the ground.
Wentz now on 3rd and goal. Oh, he almost had the rare interception. The big fella couldn't hang on, though. Incomplete.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Certainly their offense has sputtered here a little bit in the first half as they finally do get on the board, but they only have 3.
Well, at least it eases the frustration a bit, doesn't it? To be able to get some points on the board, feel a little bit better about themselves as they go into the locker room and try and regroup.
And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Passing again. Dalton on second and 10. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked off by George Iloka. And he will score. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Charles, I'm looking at you, and understandably, your mouth is wide open in disbelief. What were they thinking?
That's going to be one of the great mysteries, but I do know this. When they went out on offense, I will guarantee they told them, don't just make anticipatory throws. Make sure you see it before you throw it. Didn't happen here.
Trying to protect that lead, and now they gave it up. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. They'll send Rice in motion. Passing, it's Dalton. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
First and 10 for Dalton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Malcolm Smith coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Dalton up, play action. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock.
I know we're just in the second quarter and there's a ways to go in this game, but that's his second drop. I'm wondering if that's a little bit of an alarm bell for them when they start calling plays on the offensive side of the ball.
His eyes already looking upfield on that last one before he brought it in. Third and long. What will Dalton dial up? And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field, it's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. And this is going to be incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. It's a short kick taken near the 18. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Out come the Colts. They'll have it first here to start quarter number three. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points?
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super tall.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of two. Now third down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side, but for lost yardage.
Terrific read. Better execution and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for Los Angeles.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Ray Lewis coming in to drop him for a loss of eight, and it'll be fourth down.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. You take it right on the 30. Nice job on the return there. 16 yards. And that will come the offense as they take over. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. Another look for Dalton on second and 10. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. Dalton now to pass. And he's got an open man. It's Gronkowski. Touchdown! Rob Gronkowski, 30 yards. And his guys are able to strike for six. And nowadays in NFL football, you have to account for all the receivers, sure, but the tight end's such a weapon. And they prove it right there.
Oh, without a doubt. And we're seeing now the golden age of tight ends catching the football. I go back to Kellen Winslow. Uh-huh. To me, he was a prototype of what we're seeing today. We're seeing it each and every week now.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fairly short kick, taking it to 14 here. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick. But instead it falls down incomplete. Play action. Now Wentz. Gets it to Bellamy outright. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. First down, here's the run with Martin. And he'll be brought down at what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Colts, so they've got the football, but they've got work to do, trailing here as we begin the fourth quarter. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now Wentz. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Give them five on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
This is third and two. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. Now Wentz. And incomplete. Almost intercepted. The D lineman almost had it. Couldn't hang on. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Brian Arakpo. Tough to handle on that blitz. He gets him for a loss of five. Well, their first fourth down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a second time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. If you're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any fourth down stop is a big momentum play.
It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Dalton sets up play action. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Champ Bailey. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. Now the Colts offense gets ready to head back on the field. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Back to the air on second down. Wins. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
The Colts on third down, a pretty woeful 0 for 5 thus far. This is third and 10. Now Wentz. They set up the screen to Martin. The screen gets seven, but it's not enough, and it will be fourth down. He got out of bounds. That's a good thing, but still short of the first.
And now, since this brings up fourth down, the defensive play caller, grab your nerves, because now you don't want to be so amped up that you give them a first down by getting out of your lanes, but you also don't want to just lay back and let them have it easily.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Wentz, gotta have this one. It's complete, swings it out to his running back. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. Call it a pickup of 7. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. On first down, Wentz. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And it'll be second and 12. Back to throw. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
The Colts on third down, they're struggling. 0 for 6 thus far. This is third down and 12. He's back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Champ Bailey.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the 2-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. And now here's a timeout called by the Colts on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They stay on the ground. Tomlinson. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
In motion, Gronkowski. Now Tomlinson up first and 10. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. They run with LT, and that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
They lost 2 and it brings up 4th.
So statistically, both of these offenses having a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right. You look at the numbers, neither side looks on track in the ground game. So they're forced to punt on 4th as this one's away. This is taken at about the 14. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. They'll run for it. It's Tomlinson going absolutely nowhere. He'll wind up losing a yard or two. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.